tomatoes diagonally on the top through till the middle. Boil them in a saucepan until it reaches a rolling boil. Let them cool. Peel the tomatoes carefully and dice them. The sauce tastes better without the peel. Now, cut the tomatoes diagonally on the top through till the middle. Boil them until it reaches a rolling boil. In a food processor, blend 2 cups of basil and parsley. Add peeled tomatoes to the blender and add a little bit of water to blend all ingredients well. Now, blend 2 cups of basil and parsley. Now, to this, add the peeled tomatoes. So anything that goes into a food processor should always be cut a little chunky. It won't be able to manage blending it well otherwise. Next to this, add a little bit of water to make a paste. Heat 2 tablespoons of cooking butter in a deep pot. Add herbs and tomato mixture to it and stir well. Next, add 400 grams of tomato puree to it and bring to a boil. Add seasoning, salt and sugar. Heat 2 tablespoons of cooking butter. To this, add the herbs and tomato mixture. It splutters and splashes a little, so be a little careful. Next, add the 400 grams of tomato puree to it and bring to a boil. Add salt and sugar. Sugar is needed to balance the tartness of the tomato puree. Next, add some dried oregano. After that, add pepper and chili flakes. You always need to taste test your sauce. You need to add the pizza seasoning. So this is one of those things that I always buy store-bought. Kia One is one of my preferred brands. It's easily available. Next, you need to simmer it for 5 to 6 minutes. After which, the sauce is ready. Now is the base. Warm 2 cups of water to about 100 to 110 degrees Fahrenheit. Add sugar and yeast. Keep in a warm place for about 6 minutes to bloom. In a deep dish or parath, add 4 cups of whole wheat. Then add 2 cups of maida or all-purpose flour. After that, add salt. Warm 2 cups of water. Add sugar. Add yeast. Keep in a warm place for up to 6 minutes. In a deep dish or parath, add 4 cups of whole wheat flour. Next, add 2 cups of maida or all-purpose flour. Add salt. Add 7 tablespoons of oil next. Make a well and add the bloom yeast. Knead the dough for about 5 to 6 minutes. Add a little water and oil to your hands if it sticks while kneading the dough. Now, add the 7 tablespoons of oil. Here in the video, I have only about 6. make a well and add the bloomed yeast. Mix well with your hands. Knead the dough for about 5 to 6 minutes now. It takes time. This dough is rather sticky. Now, as you can see in the video, it is sticking to my fingers. So I've added a little bit of oil to my fingers and hand, and I'm using that to help me knead the dough better. So you can see the dough has become soft almost immediately. Now I've added a little bit of water as well because the weather is fairly dry here in Hyderabad. Oil two deep balls with a narrow base. Divide the dough into two. Cling wrap them and keep the dough in a warm area. It needs to double in size. It took me an hour. Preheat your oven and keep the dough beside it. That's an area that always stays warm. I am transferring the dough now into two well-oiled bowls. I have divided the dough into two because it helps in proofing better since the quantity is more. When the dough is proofing for an hour, you can cut your veggies of your choice. After an hour is done, you need to second proof your dough. Preheat your oven to 200 degrees centigrade for 20 minutes. Mix the divided dough and knead it for about 1 to 2 minutes. This is the final proofing. Divide the dough into 8 equal sized parts. Tuck the doughs in, make them into small balls. Keep aside for second proof next to the warm oven. After 15 minutes, second proof is done. Mix the divided dough. Now knead it for 1 to 2 minutes. Next, divide the dough into 8 equal sized parts or portions. So this dough basically can give you 8 large pizzas. We made about 6 or 7. Keep aside for second proof next to the oven for about 15 minutes. Flatten the dough to the center of the pan. Work the dough through the edges of the dish. Keep the edges thicker. Add oregano and mix dried herbs and some grated cheese to the base. Now add the prepared sauce. Add veggies, seasoning and cheese per taste. Flatten the dough from the center of the pan to the edges. Work the dough through the edge of the dish. Always keep the edges thicker. Add some oregano and mixed dry herbs and add some grated cheese to the base. Next, add the prepared sauce. Add veggies, seasoning and cheese. I have added tomatoes, basil, peppercorns, baby corn and sweet corn. Yes, overboard. And I added some jalapenos as well to add a little bit of a spicy kick to it. You can add paprika as well to give it a bit more tartier taste. And spicy, of course. Add some mozzarella on the top afterwards. Right at the end before you pop it into the oven. Bake in an oven that is preheated for about 12 to 15 minutes. The first one usually takes a little longer. Take the pizza out of the oven, let it cool for 5 to 6 minutes before transferring it to a plate. Serve the pizza with additional seasoning and enjoy it. Cool the pizza, then cut, and then serve. Thank you. As always, like, share, and subscribe.